What's up, guys, and welcome back to an old favorite. Welcome home, baby. It's been quite the journey. It's been quite the wait. But y'all know what time it is. Welcome to MLB 21, the show. Dude, I'm so excited for this. I've had this date marked on my calendar for so long, and we are going to have so much fun with this game. So today in this video, we are going to be starting up our road to the show. You guys know we've played it every year for the past like 5 years or so, and I can't wait. Some new exciting features and stuff happening this year, but also we are going to be checking out Diamond Dynasty. That series will probably start up sometime in the next couple of weeks, so be on the lookout for that. So, hope you guys are excited. Thank you guys so much for being here. Shout out to all my Xbox fam out there playing the show for the first time ever. Welcome to the club. You guys have missed out, but I'm glad you've got access now. There is one admission I've got to make before we're getting started. Your boy is juicing. The juice, baby. New G Fuel flavor. I'm going to be grinding this game so hard, dude. We've got so many videos on the way. So if you guys want to pick up some G Fuel for yourself, use my code. It's actually bumped up to 30% off for this weekend only through Monday. So top link down in the description. Use code TMartin. Save yourself some dough and enjoy. Thanks to G Fuel for sponsoring and putting on a cool promotion for a brand new game. This new menu's We're hitting dingers. Yeah, dude, he's gonna be sick. So it looks like they have his first name. They don't have dingers in the audio catalog. Come on, MLB, you gotta get your stuff together there. 15 sounds good to me. Right-handed thrower, batter. Gonna be from the East Coast, from Florida, baby. And okay, let's move on to our physical appearance. So being from Florida, we're probably gonna be a little bit tan. So let's just, you know, kind of go with something like that, maybe. Height, I'm gonna go, let's make him 6'5". Weight, you know, he's been working out a lot. He's been cutting, he looks pretty good. He's gonna be a buff body type. Medium neck size, arms, spine. Not to get too crazy here. Thighs. Thick thighs save lives. Dude, we've got so many options for customization here. I mean, something like that maybe isn't bad. I don't want to spend too much time. It's just, it's always been crazy. Hair, I'm thinking, short tail top. That actually doesn't look too bad. I kind of like that. Color, we're going to go a little bit lighter brown. Looks good. We've got 5 pages of facial hair to choose from here. This is crazy. I feel like Dirk, he's going to need something like I like the milkman on him. I think a lot of our equipment and stuff we're going to change as time goes on. We're going to, you know, make it our certain team colors and just kind of make it all match together. So to start things off, we're going to keep it fairly casual here. And let's, take a look at his loadout. So this is, we're picking like perks and stuff. I was thinking we were going to play third base this year. I was thinking infield might be kind of fun. We haven't played third that often. We played a lot of short, a lot of second. You know, some outfield. I was thinking third base might be fun. So we've got slugger and then power 1 and contact 5 underneath that. I think we're going to be able to change these and develop them over time. So we'll see what happens. I think we're good to go, baby. Road to the show. We're going to start up a brand new one. Use those current rosters. And here we go. A new beginning.
MLB draft already underway. A young prospect shares his expectations with a former coach.
We're already into the MLB draft. Uh-oh. Been talking to any particular team? I just want to play for the club that wants me the most. No favorite team you're pinning your hopes on? Not really. Let's just roll the dice, see where it goes. It's probably for the best. Not yours to decide anyway. All right.
Carlos, you lived that in your baseball career. What's this world like?
Oh, it's extremely exciting. You know that if you perform, you will get the call.
We've got a developing story here. JP, what are you hearing?
I'm checking the numbers, I'm talking to my sources and my scouts, and they're all telling me, hey, this could actually work.
Most of us mere mortals, when we were that age, we were barely chewing gum and walking at the same time, let alone playing the hardest game there is.
That Sammy's pumping up mentally here to adapt. That's what good players do.
That dream of getting the big leagues is now becoming reality with that one phone call.
The Phillies, dude. No, okay. This is kind of cool. This is a bit different than what we've seen before. We're going to Philadelphia.
Continuing our MLB Draft Day 2 wrap-up coverage, back to the prospect that we mentioned before the break. There was some surprise, even some criticism of the front office over how early he went off the board. Jonathan Mayo, what do you think of this pick?
Man, I don't think any of us saw this one coming. This definitely feels like a reach to me. I had him more as a day three kind of guy. There was a split camp. A lot of scouts disagreed whether he's better as a pitcher or better as a hitter. I'm guessing the team felt that he's got potential on both sides of the ball, and maybe that adds some value to him. But this made me scratch my head a little bit for sure.
All right, Jonathan Mayo, thanks. What about you, Jim Callis? Was this a head-scratcher or the reach of the draft, as some of the other analysts have suggested?
Yeah, you know, I talked to somebody with the team, and they're excited to get this guy. This is a guy they really want. And the two points the club made to me were, one, you know, this whole debate, is he a hitter, is he a pitcher? You know, what are you going to do with him? There was a lot of confusion. This team isn't confused. This team feels like he's got very good potential as a hitter and as a pitcher. They may even try to play him both ways. And they felt like there were a couple other teams that were starting to sniff around this guy. And, you know, this isn't the NFL or NBA draft where you could trade down to get a guy you want. If you want a guy, you have to take him because there's no trades. And they felt like if they didn't take him where they did, somebody else was going to get them. And they just absolutely did not want that to happen.
We got high value, baby.
Appreciate the time. Thanks.
Very, you know, exciting new prospect. Everybody wanted a piece.
Checks in with one of his players to discuss a launch plan for the young man's development.
Man, Micah, our manager. So this throws a wrench in the plans. I was thinking third base. I mean, playing two ways might be kind of fun. The club is intrigued by your potential as a two-way player, Dirk. You mean pitching and position play? We're not going to force anything on you long term, but we'd like to get a look at you both ways for at least a few games. Do they have a field position in mind for me? Where do you see yourself playing in the field? I'm going to say definitely in the infield. Which spot were you thinking? Okay, so we might be able to work out both of these. We'll see. We'll give you one game on the mound and a couple in the field, and we'll touch base again. Interesting.
Rolling along with the podcast. This is exciting. And back on the prospect who's divided the scouting community, I am opposed to this belief that he went too high. I really think he could be a steal here. This is a guy who's got so much development left to do. He's got so much potential. And I think all the scouts who are down on him think, oh, he's not a finished product. We don't know what he is. That, to me, could be a good thing. He can hit.
Or malleable.
He can field. He can pitch. There is so much untapped potential so far for this guy. I'm excited to see what he becomes. And certainly as he gets started actually playing, actually being in games, we're going to be able to talk to some other folks who get a better read on him and see what they think. I'm excited for that. And frankly, I'm going to have my eye on him for a while.
Whew. Dude, this is exciting. So we skipped like the scouting and all that stuff. You usually have the East versus West games and everything. We just hopped right into it. Dirk Dingers, just straight athlete. Athletic potential through the wazoo. We can play infield. We can play outfield. We can pitch. We can catch. We can do it all, baby. Now, seeing as we might be going for a two-way player here, I did set up a new loadout. So we've got our hitting loadout here, which has slugger, power, and then also fielding because we're going to be playing third base. And then we've got a pitching loadout here, which has filthy, velocity, and control. So that way, I think we're going to be able to interchange these depending on what position we're playing. We're going to have kind of a different loadout, different set of perks, stuff like that to be able to roll with. This is kind of exciting, man. Being a two-way player is going to add some diversity to the series, that's for sure. Looks like this first game we're going to be batting cleanup. We're going to be playing at third, so we're going to want to use our hitting loadout. All right, nice. So we can kind of change up our skills and attributes depending on where we're going to be at. But yeah, dude, this isn't what I was expecting. I welcome it, though. It's cool.
Opening night here in this brand new season.
Brand new stadium, brand new season, brand new team. The Fightin' Phils. I like it. All right. So welcome to our professional ball career, baby. Starting at the very bottom, got to work our way up. Sounds like we've got a lot of potential, but potential doesn't sign checks, baby. It doesn't pay bills. You got to perform. So let's get into it. David Parkinson's going to be on the mound for us, and we're just going to go ahead and skip ahead to our next appearance. First at bat. Looks like we've got two outs. Got a man on second base in scoring position. Could potentially get our first RBI of our career. Pitcher's got a four-seam slider and two-seam. Looks like he favors that four-seam by quite a bit. All right, here we go, Trev. First pitch on its way. Grip it and rip it, baby. That's down in the dirt. Not going to be looking at that one. Runner in scoring position. Here we go. Second with two down. Come on, baby. This is big. Whoa! I feel like I crushed that slider. Get down. Yes! I'm going to stay at first. We might have been able to push second there, but that's going to be enough to get our boy home. That's going to give us a one-run lead. Let's go, baby. First double-A base hit. First at bat. First RBI. First time on base. A lot of firsts happening here. That was close. He could have potentially he could have caught that. It's unfortunate it wasn't a little bit more to the left and went all the way to the wall, but that's all right. Manager is asking us to steal base. I'm going to get back real quick, just try to play it safe. I don't know what our speed's looking like. I don't think we're that fast. I have no clue. I'm going to see if we can extend our lead a little bit. Going to get back. Now, this is actually one thing I was thinking about cutting out of the series this year. I'm curious as to what you guys are going to think. It's kind of fun that it gave this to us off the start here. Go, 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 go. Decent start, but he got us. He got us, yeah. We're just not, sorry, bud, we're just not fast enough for that kind of business yet. But the base running, now if we build a guy that's focused, ooh, that was pretty close. If we build a guy that's focused on speed and stuff, stealing bases is great, but I feel like in a lot of our previous Road to the Show series, it just got pretty frustrating, and we just watch our teammates strike out a lot, and I feel like it's kind of a waste of time. So we're going to leave base running normal for this game, but we might try something else in game two of this episode. So here we go. Here's the first pitch. Same pitcher. Ready to grip and rip. Ooh. Oh, he fumbled. Bobbled the bag right there. We'll take it. Is that going to count as a base hit, or is that an error? I would imagine it was a fairly tough play, but kind of error ballpark here. I don't know. We'll see. I think I'm going to go ahead and not steal. Definitely not going to try stealing again. Looks like they are going to turn. Oh, we're safe. Oh, we're out. Kidding me? We should have taken off there. We would have been safe. It's all right. First defensive play. Top of the sixth. Nobody on, nobody out. Just going to be going to first base. Right down the third base line there. This is going to be a tough throw. Got to get there fast. Beautiful. It's a long throw from third to first there. So it looks like that did count as a single. We're 2 for 2 in the day so far. One out, nobody on. Tie ball game in the bottom of the sixth here. This guy's starting to get a little bit more tired. Right at the second baseman. Well hit ball, well read. But not really much else we could ask from that. Unfortunately, that's just a part of baseball right there. Okay. Going to be looking at turn two here. Try to preserve our lead here in the top of the eighth. Move it on over to the home half of the inning. Come on. Get it there. Oh! Wait. And they will not get him at first as he's able to leg out the throw. Two for three on the day. Ooh, this is a big one, boys. Bottom of the eighth. We are going to be leading off for the home half here. It's a tie ball game at 3-3. This is tough. Four-seam slider, changeup, and a sinker. They've got a new pitcher in. Their closer. Chasing the changeup out there, way out in front of it. Yeah, that was not even close there. All right, we've got to be careful here, Trev. We do not want to strike out. We want to do something big for the squad, and that's going to be two. Easily two, maybe three. Not going to be able to go three. We just aren't fast enough. All right. Lead off double to start things off. That's exactly what they wanted. Now we got to do smart base running here, Trev. We got to get home. Three guys to be able to get us home. Come on now. See, situations like this where it's close at the end of the game and we're base running, I feel like this is pretty fun. Center fielder coming on. Oh, go, 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 go. Okay. Holy cow, I'm going to stay right there. He had a good throw to home. That was a good call. All right, we got two men on second and third. Maybe even sacrifice bump material right here. Let's see what they got. Got to be careful not to get picked off or anything. Shoot. He's safe. Bases are loaded. No way. Oh my goodness. We'll take that. Okay, see, this is really, this was a bad time to bring up potentially getting rid of base running because this is hype. This is really hype right here. All right, Mickey Moniak, bases loaded, 0-2 count. You can't strike out here. Strikeout and double play is going to end this run. Sack bunt, they're going to get us at home. Are you freaking kidding me? They didn't get the guy at first, though. Horrible bunt right there. You got to get it further away, man. Bottom of the ninth, we've got two guys in scoring position. Still a tie ball game with one out. All right, this is our chance, boys. Four-seam curveball changeup, but a two-seam. What a game.
Here's the first pitch.
Checked, 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 checked. Did he go around? I'm just excited. Come on. Here we go. I do have guess pitch on, I think. I'm going to guess four-seam fastball high. Oh. Go. Go. Oh my gosh, dude. Are you kidding me? Aired it out. We're going to, I guess we'll take it. I was upset. Okay, you know what? Walk off sack fly. We'll take it. I didn't even realize. I wasn't paying attention. I wanted the home run, but we'll take it. Fantastic. Holy cow.
A walk-off sack fly isn't as dramatic as a game-winning hit, but it's just as effective. Great team win right there.
Dude, I was bummed about not hitting the home run. I didn't even realize that's all we needed. That's amazing. Let's go. Walk-off sack fly to win our first game. Walked it off, baby. That's exactly what you want.
We hear all the time from people around the game that double A is where you start to see the breaking balls that are really set apart from what you've seen before. That can be a big challenge for a young hitter.
Absolutely. And I think, you know, when you think back to, you know, some of the pitchers that I faced, some of the guys that you face in the big leagues for 5, 6, you know, 10 years, you're thinking, man, I saw him somewhere. Yeah, it was double A, because when you see most prospects of any organization, they pretty much go to double A just to get themselves over that hump and get ready for the league.
You had a breakout season at the double A level yourself. What was it about you that enabled you to have that kind of campaign?
I was very confident. And I thought, you know, if the confidence could just stay with me consistently, which is very hard to do at any level of baseball because it's a game of failure, I just try to be consistent every night, whether it was, you know, defensively, offensively, you know, just bring something to the table. Go home with something where you felt good. And I didn't have to think about that game when I went to sleep.
Consistency is key, baby. So before we hop into game two, I wanted to run this by you guys. And maybe it's something that we play normally for a while. And then eventually when we get deeper in the series and we want to start speeding things up, we'll mess with it. So the base running opportunities right now, it's on action pitches. So whenever something happens, like somebody hits a ball or, you know, somebody strikes out or whatever else, that's when we have the base running opportunity available to us. You can turn it to none, which significantly increases the rate of play. And like, I don't know, last episode, that situation was unique. That doesn't happen often. I feel like most of the time when we played this game in the past, base running has usually been kind of, you know, a little bit boring and frustrating and stuff like that. So let's see how this works. We're basically only going to hit and field in this game. There's not going to be any base running. So, bottom of the second, leading off, four-seam curve, changeup, slider, and a two-seam.
Now, here's the first offering.
Got a curveball that we were trying to wait on. I was trying to be patient, but we were still way out in front of. Actually, we had good timing. We just missed it. We just whiffed it. Okay. Well, got to do better this time. That's outside. Ooh, that's in the zone. Okay. 0-2. He's got a nice lead on us. This is dangerous. That's outside, for sure. Not going to be swinging at that one. 1-2 count, just got to fight our way back. To stay consistent. Just like the advice told us. Got us up and in. See, that was kind of nasty, dude. I'm not going to lie. All right, but strikeout is fine. See, we didn't do any base running. It's like nothing happened. Ooh, our boys are down by quite a bit here. All right. First strikeout right there was not the best situation. Come on. Oh, I thought we might have gone the yard right there. Okay. 0-2. Not like we would have had any base running yet anyway. Come on, baby. We got to get on base so we can show what it looks like. Get some sort of a base hit. Got underneath that one again. Is that one going to go?
But he
Okay, so it's like, see here, there's one out, we're on second base. Rather than you know, running the bases and oftentimes our guys end up striking out and it gets really, really frustrating. We just come back up to bat again. Or if we were going to get another fielding opportunity, we'd go straight to fielding. But yeah, I don't like these side-armed guys. They're kind of hard to read. All right, we're down 0-2 here. But yeah, it dramatically increases the speed at which the game plays. Got a piece of that one to stay alive. We got to be careful, dude. These sidearm guys, I've got to retrain myself to watch here. Let's focus up.
Nothing in two count and the pitch.
Got a piece of that one. We'll go through. I don't know. A little bit of what you guys think. I definitely feel like it's got potential here. I mean, we're going to be able to get through games quicker. We're going to be able to get to the majors quicker. We're going to be able to, you know, just play more baseball, play through more seasons. It's going to cut down on the length of the games and the episodes dramatically. So we're going to be able to play more games. We are going to lose out on a few big moments, if you know what I mean. Like some interesting base running moments that happen few and farther between. So let me know what you guys think. Would you rather see a bunch of base running, or would you rather see more hitting and fielding? That's pretty much what we're looking at here. So I think that's a pretty good performance there to start things off. We were, what, 3-for-5 of the first game, 2-for-4 in the second game. We're batting above 500. We're putting the bat in the ball. We're fielding well. I think we've got some pitching coming up soon. So I'm going to see you guys there.